Dear learners, welcome back to this session on the practical demonstration of how the websites can be designed. As I have mentioned earlier, that we will be using Google Sites for designing the website, and as we go forward, you will find that it's very easy, and we don't need any kind of technical expertise for designing these websites. Also, I have mentioned earlier that we need to do some sort of pre-design work where we have to create a kind of blueprint for our website. Also, I have mentioned that we should gather the information that has to be displayed on the web page. Okay, and then this information has to be classified according to the pages where this information will be displayed. So, as mentioned, I have also done this pre-design work. I have designed a layout for the home page, how and where the objects will be placed. Secondly, I have collected all the information that will be displayed on various web pages, and then I have classified. The next important thing that we have to do in this pre-design work is to decide the flow, that is the site map, how the web pages will be linked with each other. So, this pre-design work has been done. I will first show you what kind of pre-design work I have done for designing this website. Now, the website that I am going to design is the website for the National Resource Center of our university. As I have mentioned, that it is part of this HRDC of our university. Some of the information I will be taking from the existing university web portal. I have already taken it and I have collected that particular information. So, let us see what kind of pre-design work I have performed for this website. So, now as I have mentioned that we have to create a blueprint of our website. So, I have created the blueprint, the layout of how the slides would be. Let us see that layout. So, here I have stored that layout as a PowerPoint file. Here you can see on your screen a layout of the home page of our website. You may have visited several websites and you may have noticed that the home page of any website is the most important component in any of the web design. The first impression of anything must be the best one. So, it is recommended that you should spend more time in designing the layout of your home page. So, here I have designed the home page. Consider one thing when designing any of the web page is that you should keep enough blank space on any of the web page. Keeping lots of information is not recommended, otherwise the users would spend more time in searching the information. So, in this layout I have covered most of the important components that would be displayed on our website. And one more important thing is that when we have created a blueprint, you should follow the design of this blueprint. So, you will see that when designing this web page, I will be switching through this layout frequently. Next, now as I have mentioned that we must design the flow of the web page in advance. So, I have created a sitemap where I have shown which pages are inserted under which page. Okay, so that is a kind of flow where the visitor is expected to visit my web portal. Secondly, we will now see how the information can be gathered. I have stored all the information that will be displayed on the web page in a Word document, NRC website information. Let us see what this web information consists of. Okay, so this is the information for NRC website. where I have stored the entire material that I will be uploading on my web page. There are now two ways from where I can gather the information. So naturally, I have to create my own information for most of the items. So whatever the information has to be created, I have listed it, I have written it down inside this Word document. So I will simply be copying the contents from this Word document onto the appropriate objects on my web page. Secondly, there might be some information that I may be taking from some other sources, like maybe from some another website or somewhere else. So what simply I have to do is I have to switch between those windows and get the material from that window onto my web page. So this is where I have stored the entire information to be displayed on various web pages on my website. Okay, so this was the pre-design work that I have actually carried out.